In this video, you will learn how to use the Advanced tab in the Floor Layout Modification tool to control the slab minimum angle and sloping edges, and allowed widths and lengths of the slabs. You will also learn how to control the specific and generic allowed size and settings of the slab openings and cutouts. Double-click the slab to open its properties. Go to the Advanced tab. The minimum end angle and the minimum start angle control how the slab ends are modeled. Let's change the minimum start angle for this slab. When the angle of the floor edge is smaller than the minimum angle, you can select a suitable option from the list to make the slab end straight. You can define the allowed slab width, the allowed cut zones, and the allowed slab length per profile in the Floor Layout INI file. To use the default settings in the file, select Default in the Slab Width and Cut Zone Settings list. To respect the cut zone preset settings in the file, select Yes and align openings by allowed widths. The default settings can be modified directly by editing the file. You can also create multiple definition files that you can select from the drop-down list under Slab Width and Cut Zone Settings. The settings on the right side control a higher level allowed geometries and openings of the slab. You can modify and control the minimum slab width. Minimum slab length. Minimum required width of a single neck when there is a large opening. And the minimum end nose width and length. To create cutouts for notches or openings in the slab, select Yes and Create Cutouts. To remove the cutouts from your slab, select No. Create cutout settings does not affect whether the slab is split. To create automatic cutouts for parts going through the floor layout, enter the names or classes for parts that need cutouts. As you can see, a cutout has been created around the part you specified. You can define the gap increase between the slabs when the other slab is cut inside the layout by changing the extra narrowing value.